Okay, everybody, welcome back to my top 145 Mario Kart tracks. In this part, we are doing tracks 116 to 103. Let's kick things off with Mario Circuit 2. Okay, so I like the 3DS version because there is a gliding section and we can glide quite a considerable amount of distance, but overall in the SNES version, it's just plain boring, really. Nothing to do except for the jump at the end. It's just sand and like Mario Circuit 4. Just an empty background with nothing inside except for some trees. Very bland track. Okay. So that's Mario Circuit 2. Moving on to 115, we have a Wii U DLC track and a track for the Switch, Wild Woods. The track just looks plain ugly. I mean, why even make this, Nintendo? I mean, in my opinion, I think Waluigi Pinball from the DS version would make a better DLC track than this. I mean, Mario Kart 8 just adds so much detail. There is like, everywhere you look, you can see something at least. Except for GBA Mario Circuit, but you know, I've never liked this track. Ever since the DLC pack came out, it's always been a letdown to the game. That's Wild Woods 114, Daisy's Cruiser from GCN, and Retro Track and Mario Kart 7. And gosh, do I hate this track. I mean, the compliment is we are on a cruise ship for this course. That's cool, at least. But overall, the track, it's not much of an experience. And it's like the track's very confusing. There's twisty, twervy turns all over the place. And you sometimes don't know where you're going. There is a cannon near the end of the track, which is a cool addition. But yes, that's pretty much all this track has to offer. There's the bland cruise ship with wood and tiles and not much. 113, we have another Mario Circuit track from the SNES version of Mario Kart. Mario Circuit 3. This appears as a retro track for Mario Kart Wii. This track is used to pretty much describe everything. This track pretty much describes Mario Circuit 2. Bland, boring, nothing to look at. And plus it's short and oil slicks can slow you down quite a bit. But you got the speed boost at the end, which is really the only thing cool about this track. I just generally don't like it. Okay, 112 now. Bowser Castle 3, the Super Circuit version. Appears as yet another retro track in Mario Kart Wii. Now, I don't know why it's blue, like the main road. It's not an enjoyable track to play on. Nothing really special to this track. Nintendo, you are so good at naming things. That's ironic. Bowser Castles. Bowser Castle 1, Bowser Castle 2, Bowser Castle 3, Bowser Castle 4. Nintendo, you're so good at naming things. Well done. Okay, 111. This is yet another Super SNES track. Mario Circuit 1. This is the track that started it all. It's my favorite because it's a great way to introduce the game. Introduce Mario Kart back in the day. Yes. Yeah, not much else to say about it. Okay, so I fast forwarded to the next one because it is a long track. So this is Maka Woohoo from Mario Kart 7, or Woohoo Mountain Loop for you PAL players. Now, why do I like Woohoo Loop better than this one? Okay, so really the first track is just like a race. The first section of the track is like a race. In the second section, you go into a cave and then beginning to go onto the mountain. I mean, the garden. That it's. This track is just not fascinating. There's really nothing special about this track. You're just going through caves for the second section, up the down the mountain for the last section. And yes, nothing else. Just a plain track. I mean, some people like this track, but personally, I don't. And I like the cul-de-sac at the end of the track, which signals you can't go anywhere else. And yes, that's Marco Woohoo. 109 Bone Dry Dunes from Mario Kart 8 / Deluxe. Now, I've got to say, this is quite a long track. I get bored of playing this track, and what can I say about this track? It's really not fascinating. Really, I don't think anybody likes this track. There are two alternative ways you can go. I prefer to go on the anti-gravity section, and then you head into a massive dry Bowser statue, kind of like you do with the Bowser in Bowser's Castle. And that's from Mario Kart Double Dash onwards. Bone Dry Dunes. 108, another Super Circuit track, but this time, Broken Pier. Now, something odd is, this track is much lighter than Boo Lake, and it's a ghost course, but, and so that doesn't make any sense, it's nonsense. The music, it's very catchy, especially between the 30 and 40 second mark, or 45 second mark. Other than that, the boos can easily slow you down, and if you're playing in time trials, ghost data can't be saved, which is quite a bit of an issue. Well, that looks like an odd shape, Broken Pier. Then we've gone to 107, another track of the same topic, Boo Lake, from the same game. Now I like how this track is darker, which makes the track more eerie. However, it's become way too long. Long? I'm confused. Who knows if it's long or short. Anyway, not a fun track to play on. I don't know what I just slipped up on there. And we got 2 coins. What happens if we get 0 coins? I don't know, we spin out. Okay, 106. We have another 3DS track, Rock Rock Mountain. Alright, Now, I didn't like this track ever since Mario Kart 7 came out. My first impression of this track when, the 3DS version of Mario Kart came out, it was not impressive to me. I mean, it's like, it's really based on a Mario level because of the tall cylinder-like structures in the background. No, they're cylinders or not. It's generally not a fun track to play on. It's unfun. And the leading up to the mountain. Oh, plus, it's called Alpine Pass in the PAL version. So, if you're confused why it's called Rock Rock Mountain, I just told you now, it's called Alpine Pass in the PAL version. No more explanation of Rock Rock Mountain now, because we have Thwomp Ruins right here. Now, I can tell you, we go much slower in Mario Kart 8 than we do in Mario Kart 7. Sorry about the arguing in the background. I'm trying to record. I told them to be quiet. Oh my goodness, it's an ancient track. Nothing special about an ancient track. I feel like this one should have been in the flower cup or the star cup, not in the mushroom cup. It doesn't suit to be a mushroom cup course. By its general appearance, it's very horrible atmosphere. Especially because it's ancient. And I don't like ancient tracks. Oh my goodness. Okay, another one, number 104, another Mario Kart 8 track. Cloud Top Cruise. Gosh, I hate this track because it's a successor to Sky Garden, but not a good successor. I think I would prefer Sky Garden to be in Mario Kart 8 rather than Mario Kart DS. I mean, it's based on Super Mario Galaxy, but the idea of clouds, not impressive, really. Driving on vines, nothing special. Sorry if I'm using the same vocabulary. I just can't think of any other vocabulary. Alright, last track of the video, number 103. Another Mario Circuit, but this one from Mario Kart Double Dash. There's another retro track in Mario Kart Wii. Now, I don't like most of the Mario Kart Wii tracks, especially the retro tracks, because they're very boring or not enjoyable to play on, or bland, or everything. But this one, it's just a basic Mario Circuit. What else could you ask for? Yes, what else can you ask for? Alright, that is the end of this video. Like, comment, and subscribe if you like this video. And enjoy the rest of your day. See you in the next video. Peace.